There are three Lutons in UK. I've seen them all in one day spell. I only drink tea from independent cafes in the town centre.
Oh, fantastic, thank you. Thanks.
Luton Haiku's book. Maybe some locals like them. Me, I say who cares.
Whose idea was the haiku, Luton Haiku, in the first place?
My idea.
Are you down the pub?
I was down the pub one day, and then Tim was taking it on greatly, and we all have, really. This kind of commitment doesn't come cheap. I've lost friends.
They're not Scandinavian. You can't. They've never sold a herring in here in, well, forever.
I thought the Scans would have a haiku about it.
It's not actually. We'll find one. If not, we'll write one. Tomorrow's specials is five syllables.
Tomorrow's special. Beans.
Magnificent Scans is five syllables.
For £5 sterling.
Chips and beans, that's only six syllables, isn't it?
Tomorrow's special is sausage, chips and beans.
No.
First line and third line. Magnificent Scans. And tomorrow's specials. Knockouts and haystacks to serve drinking music for the Hightown Beer Fez.
Good evening, Luton Beer Festival. We're the Hightown Knockouts.
Hello.
From Hightown. And we're going to be entertaining you for 45 minutes. We've been told to remind you that there is a quiet room in the other place, but it doesn't sell the decent locomotive, of course. Okay, here it goes.
We'll be right back.
you. Thank you, that was unexpected. Thank you.
We have got a great airport, but due to eco issues, we keep Sturm. Carbon guilt aside, EasyJet is a real boon for dirty weekends. Arthur Haley wrote Airport about the jet set, not EasyJet set.
Arthur Haley was actually born in Luton.
Yeah, and he went to school with my and Steve's dad. My dad was in the same class as him. And when I was saying this earlier, no, he wasn't writing novels at the time, he was just a child. But when I asked my dad about this in the mid 70s, when he said, oh, yeah, you know, bloke who wrote this film, because it was showing on the telly, bloke who wrote this film, I was in his class at school. I said, oh, do you still keep in touch? He goes, he doesn't want anything to do with Luton.
It's just.
He didn't take long to move away, no. I mean, I think it's like all people who make £1 million. They decide that Luton isn't good enough all of a sudden, and they move to Berkhamsted or somewhere like that.
I'm acutely aware that what we're about to show you of Luton
is not really representative, but or perhaps yeah, what any other resident of Luton might show you.
Football ground. There's the old railway to Dunstable, which is going to become a flying bus thing. That's the Bohemian Quarter. Student residences and more Bohemian Quarter.
George II is there. It's a Green King pub. And there's St Mary's behind, which of course is on the front cover of the book.
Yeah, and you can only just see the tower.
There's a large tree there. It's like an oasis area because that's where the River Lee springs up. For one of the brief moments that it's exposed to the air.
You might see it today.
Menswear. There's a chap on a mobile phone.
He's very smart, isn't he?
Hey, it's 5p here.
5p.
What's this? This is Barber's Lane, which is one of the oldest named thoroughfares in Luton. I think it dates back to the 1700s or something like that.
The River Lee runs under here. Approximately by our feet. All the great cities of the world make most of their rivers. And indeed, Luton does as well. Yeah. Pavement cafes, etc.
And you can get biscuits and custard here.
When I made my flippant remark about cafe culture, I forgot about this cafe, sorry. Is that just a ditch?
There's a river in here. That is a. It looks like condensation on a window, but it's moving.
It is. It's the river.
Well, it does. It will run under here,
right.
Under that excellent pub, which
you can come in for tea.
And then up to what's it? As he runs this way. This is a nice little area, isn't it? What they've done with it.
They've done nice work.
It isn't the Nile, but the River Lee has style. But few pyramids.
Make some noise in the back, lady in purple. There we are. Fantastic. Ladies and gentlemen, playing live as the first band on for the Luton International Carnival 2011, all the way from Hightown, is the Knockouts.
Okay, if you came here expecting the world stage, I think that's somewhere else. Although we are from the world, Hightown to be exact. So a bit of Hightown surf music for you. We'll be right back.
hands on the clock up there, is there?
Yeah.
They should get that clock working.
I think it's deliberate, yeah.
It never goes out of date.
You're going to hear the biggest bell in Bedfordshire in a minute.
Oh, yeah. Oh, is it just the gong one?
It's going to dong.
It's going to dong. Watch your ears.
Only the once, though. Quick. Well, this is not
here it comes.
What does it say?
From Luton Town Hall rings the county's biggest bell. In your face, Bedford.
The biggest bell's that.
Listen
whoa,
to
whoa, beauties.
What a big bell. Photo.
Okay.
Do you want me to take a photo of you? How do you do it? I don't know how to use these.
I don't. I've never used one of these.
Do you know how to work them?
Do you know how to operate a phone?
Is it a phone?
A camera phone.
I'll try. I've got a phone a little bit like this.
Are you a tourist?
Yeah.
Yes, Poland.
Oh, all right, good. Do you want, yeah, I've got it now.
All right, I'll take it.
Oh.
Oh, lovely.
And the statue.
Uh-huh, okay.
No worries.
English?
Yes, yeah, we're from Luton, yeah.
No.
Yeah, we were just talking about the town hall, actually.
Soldiers back from war attacked and burned the town hall in 1919.
When they burnt the first one down, they rebuilt it, and this time they put a moat around it so that there was some space between the people and the building. There's a big moat, isn't there, around it to put some sort of barrier between everyone so that they don't burn this one down as well.
Yeah. Is that a
moat? Well, I think it was a Peace Day celebration, wasn't it, ironically, and it turned nasty when I think some of the infantrymen or the everyday soldiers weren't invited to a banquet to celebrate the end of the war, the first war.
I don't think any soldiers were allowed to go to the banquet.
But the officers, obviously, were.
Officers and...
It was dignitaries, councillors and businessmen and
who were allowed to celebrate.
Who were allowed to go, none of whom had fought in the war. And the soldiers took umbrage with that, as did their families.
Someone threw something through a window, and I think they didn't mean it to burn down, but it escalated into a full-scale fire.
And there was a music shop.
Just here.
Where was it?
Just here, where Ladbrokes is, I think.
There was a music shop, and some of the soldiers took out a piano. While the town hall, they looted a piano from the shop, and they were playing Keep the Home Fires Burning while the town hall burned down.
So the thing about Luton is, you know, we can have riots and be dangerous, but, you know, we'll try and make you laugh whilst
there's
we're doing it.
There's an element of fun and irony about the whole thing, and sarcasm.
The Beer Festival, this month, 14th to 16th. I'm going Friday.
We're going to break with our tradition and sing on this one. Got a load of exotic birds, isn't it? Thank you.
This is our album we're selling tonight for £5. About half hour long. And if you buy it, you'll get a free copy of our magazine.
Whose idea is CLOD?
CLOD was, we all thought of that, but Andy thought of the name in the pub in 1987. Because we wanted to put a magazine out, didn't we? To support our musical projects. Suggestions. For what the bass player out of Queen might be called. Because no one really knows. Tip Johnson.
Tip.
Peter Nobbs. Anthony Jarvis, Derek Falstaff, Ian Smithson, Charlie Budd, Perry Hollins, Fat Bottom Bob, Sean Duggan, John Harper, Henry Matravis, Owen Lewis, could be, Phil Judd, Tim Bradshaw, or Eric Fawkes, Bernie Smith, Ian Smithson, Edward Moss,
James Allison,
Wayne Fish, Paul Feathers.
Hightown Public Labs might not be the worst in town, but best avoided.
There's blood on every surface, including the ceilings.
The Luton accent? It's bad, but at least we don't raise in inflection.
It's definitely different to other places. People think it's like London, don't they? But we were on holiday in Swanage once, and Mum was in a butcher's buying some sausages, and a woman was buying something in front of her, and she said, "Excuse me, where are you from?" And she said, "I'm from Luton." And my mum knew it because she recognised the way she pronounced sausages.
Really? How was that then?
Sausages. 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 It's sausages.
I know it's not right, but when people say Luton, it always sounds wrong.
Because you said about your sister could say the word pork, which is
Well, I don't think it's typical Lutonian, but she says pulk. And it's very amusing. If you repeat pulk.
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 Pulk. Pulk. Pulk. Pulk.
It only works with products that are from a pig.
Beer can.
Beer can.
What?
Beer can.
Is beer can related to a pig?
No. Beer can.
Oh, I know. Bacon. That's,
yes.
That's what I'm trying to say.
Luton folks eat out, but mostly out of cardboard. Flocks of deep-fried fowl.
If you like chicken, you'll love Luton. There's a lot of chicken places, aren't there?
Evidently chicken town.
The bloody dew is bloody vile, bloody mouths and bloody mouths, bloody babies, bloody cry, bloody flowers, bloody die, bloody food is bloody mop, bloody drains are bloody fuck, colour scheme is bloody brown, evidently chicken sounds.
Quail is not so popular.
Beatles played here thrice, 63 to 65. Never played Watford.
The Beatles played there.
What year did they play there?
1964.
What possibly?
Well,
they played first at the Odeon, didn't they?
It's humbling to think this might be one of the streets that John Lennon walked down.
Notable Lutonians include John Hegley.
Drew Talbot. He's not particularly Talbot. It's not all about sounds.
Arthur Haley.
Ian Cashmore.
Mick Abrahams out of Jethro Tull. Danny Cannon. Jonathan Barnbrook. Kerry Dixon. Kevin Blackwell. Kevin Foley. Leon Barnett. Liam George, Monty Panazar, Sean Gallagher, Stacey Dooley, Steve Dillon, Mark Titchener, Vaughan Savage, Will Smith.
Luton's Paul Young sung Wherever I Lay My Hat and a song called Toast.
Paul Young's sister used to work in this building here, which actually is Luton Borough Council, and she worked in the wages department. putting into the computer the wages of street sweepers, dustmen and toilet attendants.
Did you know her?
Yes.
Dad used to know Paul Young's dad and mum used to know Paul Young's mum. Yes. None of us knew Paul Young.
I used to work with somebody who worked with him at Vauxhall and he said he was always singing.
Yeah. Just say he was a nice chap.
I think he said he was just always singing. Sounds a bit tiresome.
We saw Mark E. Smith drinking up the road here.
Ian Anderson
lived in
Ian Anderson did live here?
In a road called Studley Road, which is just not far from where we are, in a flat, in a large converted house. Yeah. And he used to practice the flute every day for hours, as you might expect. And I don't know who was in the rest of the house, builders or whatever. And someone did say to him once, you ought to file all those knobbly bits off your flute. And he said, why? Will it make it sound better? He said, no, it will hurt less when I stick it up. Oh, this is where Diana Dawes used to work. The English Rose, public house. They've got a pergola in the garden, which is dedicated to her. It's got her name engraved above. It's where all the smokers go.
Nice touch.
A smoking shed.
A pergola.
Yeah,
it's what
this is what she would have wanted.
My now wife used to come to the Arndale on a Saturday with her friends when she was 10, searching for Paul Young. They thought he'd be out buying his aftershave or whatever from Boots.
How many times did they catch him? Most weeks?
No, they never caught him. No. Surprisingly, he was never...
Old Spice Man.
Yeah, he was never in Luton Arndale, ever.
Man in Pub helped build the Arndale Centre in wave of optimism.
The Arndale Centre opens 6:30 a.m. Shops sometime later. The Arndale Centre used to have at least 3 toy shops where one could buy stink bombs.
Toilets lack privacy, don't you think?
Pub for real ale, Bricklayer's Arms in Hightown. They sell lager too.
This pub, it's where a lot of all this is put together, I suppose, really. The great oiler, the great social oiler, and things like the haiku stuff, I guess bits of clod. It's where we come and relax, or where we have done for years. Since 1988 or something?
Seven.
Have you ever played here, performed here?
No, sadly it's not got a licence or a stage or anything like that, but there is a
license
pub over the road which
or an inclination.
Has had. We played there, but not here. Sadly.
We'd bring down the tone, wouldn't we, of this place?
That's a good
I won white slippers and tiny shaving kit at Bricklayer's Pub Quiz.
Deliberating, I missed out on going to the Bricklayer's Arms.
Mr. Talbot,
You could film me if you like while you read it.
No, you'll just look much better than us in your Sunday fashions.
Right. Shall I read it?
Yeah, go on. I just.
Talbot informed us there are few black tribute bands. He hates tribute bands.
That's true. Is that true?
Yeah.
Good.
Oh, that's good. Hat factory.
That's about it for hats.
The showroom, you can go
sadly
in and buy a hat.
Is this all that remains of?
Not quite, but there's two or three like this sort of size.
That's a big hat. Oh, I like hats. I think I'll go and have a look at that.
Come and have a look through this letterbox. There's some shit behind here.
Take the gander through there.
Oh wow.
Yeah.
Best Western. The CLOD office.
That was clearly the manager's office at one stage, and yeah, possibly still is.
Good morning, can I help you?
Well, I saw the big hat sign outside, and I love hats.
Yes, we make hats here.
Oh, fascinating.
Would you like to have a look around?
I'd love to.
My name's Tony.
Pat.
You come this way.
Thank you.
Hats, motors and beer. Industry used to thrive here. Not as much these days.
What happened to hats manufacturer in Luton?
I think just wearing hats went out of fashion. Yeah. I'm not sure when, but...
Look how many people have got hats that aren't baseball caps. Or on the wrong way. Not many people.
I can't see one person with a baseball cap on the wrong way. I'm sure there are a few.
Bring back the boater. Back local millinery, not New York Yankees.
This is a nice building. This is actually, I'm sure it's working building, you know, so they haven't got time to do it, fancy stuff, but...
They haven't got time to do a fancy size.
I'd do one.
You should do
one,
Steve.
I'll go and get a bit of paper and some gouache now if they want one.
Post it through the letterbox.
So, how's this for a sign?
You should do it.
First brick construction in England, Britain, possibly
the world.
Possibly the world.
Mm. Well, the building company who provided the bricks, they must have had a building as an office.
It's probably about a wood type.
It's a wattle and door office, wasn't it?
Would you buy bricks off a builder that didn't have a brick building?
Summary's castle, De Montfort's grand palace, needs a bit of work.
Bizarrely, this is where the modern meets the old world, isn't it? It's a photograph, but I don't know which of the houses that Joseph Conrad used to live in. But to read from this volume, The Secret Agent, Conrad novel published when Joe lived in Luton. Conrad actually lived just over in one of these buildings behind the castle.
So the eggs are for sale at number one. We could go and pretend that we're buying eggs, or actually buy eggs, and then ask if they know anything about Joseph Conrad.
Polish novelist and obsessive sea enthusiast Joseph Conrad lived briefly in Summary's farm. A building made from the bricks of the partly ruined Summary's gatehouse. Conrad moved to Luton at a time when he was suffering an acute mental condition, which could not have been helped by the antics of the fledgling football team, nor the fact that Luton is one of the most landlocked places in Britain. He wasn't here long, but he was writing under Western Eyes at that time, and he was really losing his mind at that point in Luton. Funny that.
And LU3,
it's been attacked. We're way outside LU3. That's postcode is wrong.
LU3?
That's the hospital, isn't it? LU3, that's Luton and Dunstable Hospital. LU3.
Bruce Springsteen, the boss, wrote, "Born in the LMD." He just spelt it wrong.
Beautiful. I'd like to think we've all learned something today.
I certainly have.
Finding beauty here can be tough work sometimes, though it's a worthwhile quest.
Going down.
Artists in Luton doggedly rattle inside the hat factory.
are you?
Shall we? There's nothing else worth seeing, is there?
No, not really.
No, let's go.
We've exhausted it.
Mind you, seen it in a good light.
Yeah. Look, there's loads of it on the floor. Look,
money everywhere.
Yeah.